from the heart of Discord and Facebook's fuckable fucking stupid fuckface, this is Podzilla After Dark here on the Podzilla 1985 Network. My name is Seanan Young, the captain of F-bombs. Here with me, of course, is the lovely and beautiful Jesse Kimball.
I think that Mandy is still the king and queen of F-bombs somehow.
Well, she's not here to defend herself, so I can say what
she's
I want.
She's just the god of F-bombs.
Yeah, there you go. She is the F-bomb deity.
To my right, if you're watching this on the live stream, Lindsay Wolfgang.
But is the live stream working? Because clearly it's not.
I can see people's...
At least not for us.
I can see people's messages on my phone, at least. And then, of course, Shelby Chan. So here's the situation we got going. Normally, we like to prattle on for a little bit before the show and, you know, talk to the fans and do some pre-show antics. But today, Facebook decided not to update the chat. So we are struggling to keep up with any comments that we get. And that's frustrating. So we decided to just jump into the show.
I can see it. I just have to scroll.
Like, so
I have to look over it. If I see the scroll bars now at the bottom, I have to scroll down.
Yeah, mine completely stopped scrolling. Like, there's no option at all. I had to jump on my phone to see it. So that's where I'm at. That's just who I am right now.
Said no.
So it's going to be one of those days. This is the last official show of the week. Tomorrow we're going to be... tomorrow's a party. Tomorrow is the first official Podzilla 1985 party. Well, I guess not the first official. Every time we do a milestone show.
I don't get to go because I have to be an adult and work.
You can go. You just have to come after work and you refuse to do so.
No, because I have to turn around and open at 8 a.m., which means I'm going to have to get up at freaking 6:30.
Can she see me?
Yes.
No. Okay, so everyone but Lindsay's going to be there. We're going to Double H's house and we're going to party a little bit. Steven's bringing the wine. I'm going to hide the wine bottles in my neighbor's dumpsters so that way they don't know how much I drink per week. I'm going to go up there with a sign that says, barkeep, I want to die tonight. And Hunter's going to take care of me. Kaz will be there.
Get you all that pizza.
No, I don't want pizza.
There's going to be so much pizza.
I think I may keep with tradition and pregame before I get there.
Shelby's new tradition for any party at Hunter's house.
Yeah, the last time we had a party at Hunter's house, Shelby, never mind. I was going to make some jokes, but that's okay. Shelby had a good time. That's all I'll say.
Shelby had a great time.
Shelby had a great time. So yeah, we'll be live streaming part of it here on Facebook because we want you guys to see us all together because we haven't been together physically in a year.
Halloween.
Well, not everybody could be there for Halloween though. I think the only two people from the show that's not going to be there tomorrow is Dalton and Asa, and I think that's because nobody invited them. No, hear me out. Asa, I know, probably wouldn't come anyway because Asa's generally usually busy. Dalton probably would come, but we didn't invite him. So Dalton, if you're seeing this, hey.
They actually did both get invited because Hunter invited everybody in the legendary group chat.
Okay.
As well as the Call of Duty chat.
So what?
So we might even see a Cody Sandusky up there.
I doubt it. Cody never shows his face around me. It makes me feel bad. It makes me feel like he doesn't like me. I know he doesn't. So that'll be tomorrow night. We'll live stream a little bit of it here on Facebook. You can see us having fun. All of us together. Me, Jesse, Shelby, Kaz, Hunter's lovely wife, Sarah, Steven, who is on the show sometimes. Tanner will be there. It's going to be a lot of fun. Or it won't be. We'll see. Tanner's talking about bringing the Blair Witch board game.
I'm thinking about bringing code words.
Code names.
Can't we all just drink and not play games? Or if we're going to play, like play Super Nintendo or something. You guys and your card
That'll
games.
Be there too.
I'm aware. I hate this camera. I just want to point that out. I hate the fact that I have to use Discord for the camera. I can't use anything else. So my picture quality is always garbage. And I absolutely hate it. Anyway.
I mean, you look fine on stream. You just look weird in Discord.
That bothers him even more.
Yeah, because I'm looking at myself the entire time. And I hate it. All right, Jesse, let's kick the show off proper. Motherfucker of the week.
Oh, who we got?
Kid Rock.
Oh.
Oh, what did, the fuck did he do?
What did garbage can come to life?
That's a name I haven't heard for a while.
That's a name not many people have spoken in a while. So,
last time I heard about it, didn't he play at that rally in Sturgis?
Probably, but a lot of people played at that rally in Sturgis. Including Chris Jericho.
That was the other one I was thinking of. Yeah,
including Bone Thugs and Harmony.
I was about
Harmony.
To say, Bone Thugs and Harmony playing Sturgis. Oh, it's dumb.
So Kid Rock, motherfucker of the week, you ask why. He was at a concert a couple of days ago. You call it a concert. He may have just been singing at a bar because he was drunk. I don't know. It's Kid Rock. And people were filming him with their phones, right? They had their iPhones out and they were filming it. And Kid Rock flipped them all off and called them faggots. You know, just, yeah. So that's bad enough, right? But then the backlash came out because the videos came out and everybody's upset about it. And then Kid Rock posted on Twitter that if Kid Rock calling you a faggot offends you, you probably are one. So.
Oh.
Yay, Kid Rock.
Kid Rock was popular in the early 2000s.
Was it that late?
And that's how everybody, I think,
thought so. It was like late 90s.
It was late, mid that's to late 90s. Yeah.
I know, like, he was popular in the late 90s, but I remember a lot of movies featuring music from Kid Rock.
He was the Linkin Park of his era.
Ooh.
It was Kid Rock, Linkin Park, 21 Pilots. That is the movie soundtrack progression.
I forgot he was, it was the late 90s, early 2000s when he was popular. Because, like, a lot of his songs... Where is the Wikipedia link so I can actually see?
It said no.
Michaela said the last I heard of Kid Rock was whenever WWE used one of his songs for WrestleMania. Yeah, that was a while back. In fact, I think was it The Undertaker used the Kid Rock as his theme song for a while before they switched over to Limp Bizkit. I can't remember which one it was, though. Maybe I'm dreaming of it. I don't know. Point is, Kid Rock has always sucked.
Yes.
I can recall one Kid Rock song I like, maybe two, but I always thought, I mean, he just looks like a garbage human being. Like, he looks, if Harry Potter could bring a pile of syringe needles and meth bags to life, it would look like Kid Rock. He is the human embodiment of addiction. He looks terrible.
So yeah, he got his first award nomination in 1999. And then
for what? Biggest asshole?
Best rock video and best new artist.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because it was, oh yeah, it was Ba Wita Ba in 1999 that got him nominated.
Those clever lyrics, ba da da ba da bang da bang, diggy biggy something up something. I don't know, fuck him. Samantha said the first curse word she ever said was ass because of Kid Rock, so fuck him.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
He was also nominated for a Grammy for Ba Wita Ba in the year 2000.
Why?
So yeah,
this is gonna be when I stopped listening to radio and just like listened to J-pop all the time.
J-pop, so that was a fun time now.
And regardless, like late 90s, early 2000s is when everybody was talking about talking like that. That's when, like, you know, everything was retarded, and if, you know, they didn't like you, they would call you, like, especially on video games. Like, you know, they just drop faggot out of nowhere.
I'm glad we've matured as a nation that we no longer say that when we're mad at video games. We've matured enough to say the N-word whenever we are mad at somebody in a video game. Jesus fucking Christ.
Shannon, you gotta back off from calling people nerds.
Oh my God. I swear to God, you keep saying nerd, I'm gonna fucking come through this computer screen and choke.
choke my own dick. I actually have been, I've been reading a bunch of older Image comics that, you know, got super popular that I've always been meaning to check out, like Invincible, because that, you know, recently at Amazon, and I wanted to read it.
It's because you're a nerd.
And it definitely reads. Yes, I am. it reads like it was made in the early 2000s, like where they were constantly saying shit like, this is totally gay. This is gay, right? Is gay, and like it, I mean, that didn't happen often, but it would happen like at least once every three books. And it's like, all right, this was definitely, because it started in 2003.
Yeah, there was definitely a time period where that was in popular culture to say things like that.
That's just what you said back then. Like, and we're all guilty of it. That's just what you did.
I'm trying to recall if I don't think I ever said the F-A-G word much. I did say things were gay because I was a stupid child and I did not understand that. I didn't understand the ramifications of what I was saying.
I also very rarely said that word. But yeah, I know. I would say, just like everybody else, like all my other peers, like, man, that shit's gay.
Lindsay, you look very concerned.
No, I'm not.
She's worried whenever we start talking about controversial topics like this of what I'm going to say, because Seanan is notorious for saying stupid things.
You want the reality check? I'm just playing puzzle games on my phone.
I guess it's better.
It looked like she was hitting just a real contemplative moment, like, oh God, what are we doing here?
I guess it's better doing these shows. You're
giving me way too much credit.
If we do these shows virtually, I can't see Lindsay at the table drawing or playing DS like we used to do when we all sat around the table recording together. I remember times when it would be me and you and Jesse and other people, and Jesse and I would be looking at each other with dead eyes because nobody else at the table is paying attention. We're just staring at each other thinking like, Jesus Christ, this show should just be like one-on-one with me and Jesse because no one else is paying attention. I got yelled
Everybody else just got their phones out.
They got like, their phones out. They're playing DS.
I have nothing intelligent to add to the conversation at the moment.
Yeah, I guess Lindsay, I will at least give her credit that she did seem to be paying attention while she was playing her puzzle games and doing or doodling or whatever else. But then, like, whenever you would get somebody that, you know, would just be on, you know, Twitter or, like, something like that, just, like, actively reading stuff.
Or fucking Dalton, when he became single and he was just on every dating app, scrolling constantly and swiping.
Yeah, just, yeah, I was about to say, I sit there and, like, see him at the table, just fucking, like, swipe. Motherfucker, I know what you're doing. And then, like, I'll say something like, what do you think, Dalton?
Hmm?
Silence.
Yeah.
What? Dalton.
What? What'd I miss?
Get off OKCupid for 5 minutes. 5 minutes, please.
An hour is all I ask.
That's too much.
Just the show.
But now we find
Jesse, did you watch the new Netflix trailer for He-Man?
No, I haven't yet.
You need to watch it. I want to watch it.
Yeah, I'll give it a look. Importantly, though, like I've never been a big He-Man guy. So I never watched like the original 80s stuff or anything.
I guess it was a little, they weren't really running it later as much. Like the toys were just out.
He-Man.
I definitely saw a lot of the toys.
I think pretty sure my dad thought I was gay because of He-Man. Because
She-Ra?
I wanted to buy the She-Ra toy instead of He-Man. And I never understood my dad's logic of thinking, my boy must be gay. He wants this toy of this hot blonde girl with large chest. Why doesn't he want the half-naked man with the muscles everywhere?
So Kaz jumped in, but he jumped into the wrong channel and put video on and everything and then left. And he has to jump back in. Like, I wonder if he, because he jumped into Just Chilling. So I wonder if he knows, like, if he knows that there's another channel.
Michaela, was He-Man a good show? No. No, it wasn't. It was a cartoon designed to sell toys. So
literally,
yeah,
literally, like
it was designed to sell toys to, you know, younger boys. Like that's, you buy the action figures, the big Hulk and muscles and the swords and the violence.
Oh yeah,
violence.
That was most like, of the cartoons in the 80s.
Like every cartoon in the 80s, like if it was for boys, like it was just a lot of violence and explosions and
military
guns
and cars. Yeah.
And I thought that was the dumbest shit I'd ever seen until I saw some of the shit Lindsay watched, like Jim and the Holograms or.
Don't diss on Jem. I love Jem.
What else was there? There was Little Strawberry Girl.
My Little Ponies, Strawberry Shortcake,
that's
Moon
it.
Dreamers, Lady Lovely Locks, Popples.
And Lady Lovely Locks shows
existed exclusively to sell toys.
And I have all of them. Rainbow Bright.
I was about to say, didn't Rainbow Bright have one too?
Yeah. No, I've got almost an entire Rainbow Bright collection.
Now compare that to us boys. Ninja Turtles, G.I. Joe,
Transformers.
Transformers, He-Man. Like, we had the good stuff. We had the good stuff.
That was also designed to sell toys. Yeah.
I watched all of these.
Yeah, though I still love
Thundercats, Silverhawks, Brave Star, Dino Riders.
I barely remember Silverhawks, but I know I had all of the toys because I thought the toys just looked awesome.
Yeah, they're all metallic.
Yes, that's the ones. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I thought that, and I had a bunch of G.I. Joes. The problem with G.I. Joes is that there were too many G.I. Joes. Like, there were so many Joes.
I never had G.I. Joes. I had a bunch of Turtles, a whole bunch of Batman. They made so many Batman figures.
I had a lot of Street Sharks.
I love Street Sharks.
You had Street Sharks? Oh.
They were jawsome.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I had a bunch of Batman toys, bunch of Turtles, and a whole bunch of Transformers.
Hey, it's so
there's
cool.
Kazman.
Greetings.
Hey.
Oh, shit.
He's doing the Tanner. I know he's got his...
And there's a double H.
I don't know who that was at first. It was just a dark, evil face. All right.
If I do it just right, with this shirt, you can't see. Hang on. Because it's so black.
Because he also wants to be a disembodied head like Jesse.
Yeah, I was going to say, in just the right space, it's just the head.
Jesse's just a head right now.
Oh, I'm doing my best.
I'm a head propped up my hand.
People are throwing a lot of...
I'm
getting a lot of names in here real quick. Huh? We got Thundercats was mentioned. Yes. So we're talking about old toys. Thundercats.
Oh. I loved Skeletor and Orko. They were my two favorites.
That's Tanner's Ghostbusters.
Mask. Brian Tanner says Mask. I vaguely remember Mask. I don't remember much about it.
I don't remember Mask at all.
No, not the Jim Carrey. Not the Jim Carrey movie. No.
There was.
Oh. The acronym.
By the way, everyone.
M-A-S-K.
Joining the show.
Yes, Michaela Ghostbusters had so many toys.
Oh, we'll get to that. I'm getting to that in a second. Yeah. Joining us via satellite, we got the Kazman down below and Double H to my left.
If I had a keyboard, I would have popped in and hit you with the, can I interest you in everything all of the time? This Bo Burnham thing will not get out of my head. Yeah. Man. It's living rent free here.
And if you would have done it's that, I would have answered with, oh, yeah.
Oh yeah. I can't do it. Right now. I just ate. My throat won't let me make that sound.
What else we got here? Beth says she still has her Transformers. I only have one Transformer and it's Starscream, aka the best Transformer. Don't at me.
I don't think I've got any of the toys I had as a kid. Half of them got burned in a house burn, so that's part of it.
In a house burn?
Yeah, lost most. Yeah, house got burned.
Way to make fun of his tragedy, Shelby.
House most of my toys, my mom is real big into yard sales. Except for, you know, getting rid of her own things because she's a super pack rat.
Oh, yeah.
But she loved yard sailing our things.
Oh, I would argue with mom $35 every year.
A long time ago on your stuff.
I remember. Yeah. So there was once, I won't name any names, but the Scarecrow, they were gone. And Lonnie went to a yard sale at their house and bought a bunch of old games that they had, like 64s, like classic stuff, and paid like $20 for the entire box. And when she found out that her parents had sold all of her video game stuff for like $20, she was livid and came to us trying to buy it all back because that was some expensive shit for $20.
I wholeheartedly believe that.
Shannon, why do you sound
like a good deal?
Why do I sound like the Kool-Aid man when I do that? No, the Kool-Aid man is, oh yeah, I'm... Oh yeah!
Oh yeah!
There's a difference.
Did the Ghost Rider? Oh yeah, there's something like Gunman.
It's a. Oh yeah! I still can't do it. I can't get it right now. I just ate.
So I take it there's some issues with Facebook comments.
Yeah, I can only see. Oh yeah, I can only see it on my phone.
Oh yeah.
I can't.
I got to message Brett Wiley and let him know. There's no way he's listening right now. But if Brett Wiley was here, I want to send him a message right now.
Just to tell him about the legend.
Just to let him know.
Yeah, I can scroll down. Like if I look and see that the scroll bar is up, then I can scroll down and I see the new messages.
That's what I was trying to do. It looks like what I need to do is too is just I have to keep scrolling.
Which is dumb. It used to like automatically like bump you down like whenever a new comment hit, but
Keep not scrolling, anymore. Scrolling, 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 scrolling. Keep scrolling, scrolling, scrolling. Okay.
Every time
Facebook sends a message, he's not on right now, but
like 15 things.
So I was also going to mention tonight.
It's the Google search thing where it's going to go, did you mean Discord? Did you mean Call of Duty? Did you mean everything that ever updates and then immediately breaks six other things afterward?
All of those things. Last thing before we jump into something fun. I don't know. I always come into the show with a plan. There's things I want to talk about.
It's been fun. What are you talking about?
It's not what I want from the show anymore. Anyway.
Weenie and the butt.
Did anybody see?
Yeah, this is a legitimate journalist, damn it.
I went to Kaz and I both.
We had a dream.
Kaz and I are legitimate journalists. Anyway,
well, I like that you can't finish that sentence without laughing.
We were at one time.
Long time ago.
Long time ago.
That's it. You got me. You got me. That was good.
Did anyone else see the video of the doctors testifying about how the COVID vaccine makes you magnetic?
Oh, the magnets?
Yes.
My favorite were the people in the background just looking, going, what the hell is this lady talking about?
I'm the one that sent you that video.
Did you send me that video? Oh, you did? Yeah. I also saw, I saw it before you sent it to me, is the reason I mentioned it.
Okay.
But yeah, so.
Yeah, no, my favorite part of that is like, fucking keys aren't magnetic.
Neither is aluminum.
My favorite part of that.
Neither is your head.
When she puts the key to her chest and it sort of sticks, so then she says it also does it to my neck, and she just can't. It just keeps falling over and over again, and she's like,
"Well, it's because she's all sweaty and nervous."
She keeps going though. She doesn't even miss a beat. She just keeps on rolling. Yeah.
She's like, "Well, can you explain this to me? Can you explain this to me?"
This is what happens.
Reminds me of the Family Guy bit where Peter's trying to scoop up the frog with the shoebox and it just keeps sliding against the wall. He's like, nah, hang on.
This is what happens when mental health is not addressed in the States. And you hand a touch person a microphone.
That woman's whole issue is because of Facebook.
No, it's like, because the COVID virus turned her into Magneto.
Sometimes I think that the internet was a mistake and that woman is sometimes.
when she walked up to the microphone, did she say, welcome to die?
It's like dumb people caught up. They learned the internet, and it's a problem for the rest of us.
Because Hunter, did you watch that video?
Yeah, I've seen it. Sorry, I'm trying to figure out why Parker's... Oh, I thought he was freaking out. He's not. He's just moving around. It was sad.
Is he magnetic? Is he magnetic?
Is Parker magnetic? Let me ask him. Bones, you magnetic?
Vaccinated. He's safe.
Oh, yeah, he is. He just got him. No, they didn't vaccinate him this year. He's at a senior age now where they only do it every so often because for like it's more potent, like the older they get or something. I don't remember exactly how it
works. Can you put a key on his head and show us?
He's been alone like all day because we were around doing stuff. If I go over there and put a key on his head, I'm coming back with blood. It will be outside of me, and I would like it to all stay inside. Magnetic, blood goes in here.
Magnetic blood.
Too much iron in my blood.
Sticking all the metal around you.
You need to put like a little Magneto hat on him.
So that's to keep the thoughts out.
Again, the blood needs to stay inside me. I don't think you understand. You'll know by tomorrow night. You'll understand.
Oh no! I'm just gonna be like, oh, he's cute, from like 20 feet away. I'm going to practice COVID distancing with that little fella.
He gets angry. He gets so angry.
Let him run. I grew up with a Chihuahua and a Pomeranian. That's an emergency room waiting to happen.
Yep.
It comes out of nowhere. Like he could be completely cool. I could be petting him for chilling, everything else, and then just very suddenly,
I'm done. You're not our.
Yeah.
If you stand up too, that's it. Like it's not allowed. As soon as you sit down, you're allowed to sit, and that's what it is. And when you stand up, it's go time.
Yeah,
it's like, let's do it.
It's go time.
He can't.
Well, because like he's suddenly like, oh, you are so much taller than I am, and he's just like that.
Yeah, let me show you how it doesn't matter. He just went right to sleep.
Trying to make this work. It's weird doing the Tanner thing. He's old hat at it. I'm still learning.
At least you've already got an advantage on him.
You've turned your thing. You'd have to be in your car. And you would have to also show us the name tag of the place that you work.
That's true.
And you're already in the horizontal form, so you're already doing better than he does. Because when he does,
that's a step up from Santa's always vertical.
So
he hits you with that mom FaceTime at 9 o'clock at night.
I went for the garage instead of the car. There are cars, but what can you do?
I've got some.
They're
really
in there. You're not in them.
Isn't running.
No, that car's not running yet. But when it does, it's going to be screaming.
If that car was running and I was in that garage, I would have a hose attached to it.
No.
And
no.
That's called suicide.
And you'd be washing it. You'd be washing the car. You run water through washing, it and you spray it.
It just give it a little bit of a polish.
Hey, I've got trivia. Mm-hmm. I've got trivia questions tonight.
What?
Where is it?
I've got the trivia questions.
Give me a break so that I can play.
And I'm fair and balanced, like Fox News.
I need something to write with.
Yeah.
So wait, what is the topic then?
General. I went for entertainment questions because no one cares about you know.
That's pretty widespread. You talking like TV, movie, ballet, what?
Yes, ballet, where the little bear gets in the car. You know.
Yes. Or the two? How about the big bald guys? The big I will pump you up guys that do the acrobatics.
Anything from the Hans and Franz?
Yes. Oh, pump.
Yeah. Kevin Nealon and Dana Carvey.
Thank you.
Oh, we lost him.
And he froze up.
I hear
that was a reach. I was throwing deep. You caught it.
Thank you and took off.
Everybody just froze up.
Yeah, we did.
No, you froze up.
No, I refuse to believe it.
I hear he does gay stunts in Little Richard movies. What is it? No, he stunts for Little Richard and gay. I don't remember how it goes.
Hey, I don't remember. Dana Carvey?
Yeah. You got it right.
Yeah.
You got it right there at the end.
Who do you hate more now in retrospect? Dana Carvey or Mike Myers? Well, yeah, we already talked about Kid Rock. Piece of shit.
Why would I hate Dana Carvey?
What's wrong with Dana Carvey?
I don't think Dana Carvey's ever given me a reason to hate him.
He did The Master of Disguise.
Oh,
turtle,
that was movie. Come on, man.
That was
everybody's done a bad movie.
That was pretty bad.
So I never really hated Mike Myers either. I mean, he did The Guru and that sucked. Or the Love Guru or whatever.
Was
stupid. But
apparently though, Mike Myers is a colossal piece of shit.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Yeah.
I did not know this.
Is that like Jerry
Garvey, I always heard is just like a super nice dude.
Hold on. Yeah. Michaela said Dana Carvey because Mike Myers plays Shrek and nobody hates Shrek. I hate Shrek.
I hate Shrek.
I'm not big
also,
on
you
Shrek.
Know who would have been a better Shrek and was almost done with the movie and then they had to redo it with Mike Myers?
Chris Farley. Oh, yeah.
Who would have been better.
Yeah.
But you can actually find there's a lot of clips out there. You can actually find Chris Farley's voice acting in Shrek. They're
storyboards.
Hit the internet at some point.
Yeah, storyboards. Yeah.
They should have. I mean, they did Chris Farley. They had Chong right there.
Chong was right there. Why would you
put Chong? Krychek was right there.
Krychong was right there.
Anyway, that's too much. You're mixing them now. This is like fourth level meme. Nobody gets it.
Yeah, but I hate Shrek. All right.
But it's the best. I'm glad movie, we cleared Shannon. That up.
Wait a minute. You might not like Shrek, but you loved Shrek 1 on DVD.
That's true.
There it is.
That's true.
There it is.
All right, so we got these trivia questions. Play along at home. These are easy trivia questions. Everyone's going to get points tonight. It's like that movie, was it PCU? Tonight, everyone gets laid. But by getting laid, it means getting points.
Participation trophies.
Does anybody remember?
Okay.
Does anybody remember that movie?
No.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Participation trophies or precipitation trophies?
No one remembers PCU?
I would like a precipitation trophy.
I'm about to get a
I get a trophy every time it rains, snows.
I'm about to get a perspiration trophy. It's hotter hell out here.
Yeah, why are you outside?
Because it feels better than inside with no air conditioning. So
you could have come here. There's so much air conditioning here. So much air conditioning. Look, that's a binary sunset. Pretty.
That's why we said 7 tomorrow night. I think I'm going to push that back to 8 because I would like the sun to go down because the intent is to stay outside. So,
yeah. Is it dark outside yet? I can't see.
No. It's kind of dark.
Yeah, but you're out. You're in Illinois. It doesn't count.
It seems darker here than it is for Kaz.
Well, it's because he's in Illinois. That's like two time stations over.
He would be dark faster than us.
Time stations.
All right, you guys ready?
Point.
What is this, Loki?
I'm looking for a tent pen. Okay.
Somebody could just pass her one.
Oh,
there
you go.
I'm good. I have it.
Hunter, do you have one?
Anybody look at the chat?
I do. I already got one.
Can you pass me one? Because I need to keep points.
Which way? This other side.
Yeah, the portal's on the other side. Yeah.
Yep, you're on this. Okay. You just hand that to me. Ready?
Yeah. Oh, thanks.
Here you go.
Appreciate that.
Okay.
Whoa.
I gotta get my own.
From my look, it looked like Jesse magically sent you one without moving.
Yeah, what you see doesn't matter. Only what I see matters. All right, here we go.
Are you checking the chat?
Question number one, and I swear to God, everyone's gonna get these right. There's no way you guys are gonna get these wrong. Question number
one. Fish tacos.
What was the first toy to be advertised on television? Welcome to Podzilla 1985 Trivia right here on the Podzilla 1985 Network. My name is Chuck Winkley. I'm going to be your host.
Chuck Winkley.
The first toy to ever be advertised?
The first toy to be advertised on... You mean Annabelle?
Yeah. No.
All right. You guys ready?
Wait.
Yeah.
Stop Googling.
I'm not.
No, I'm talking to Shelby. I can't see her on camera.
I went with part of a slinky that I straightened.
Pull it out.
Is that
Hunter gets partial points.
Correct?
He gets partial points. Lindsay, what do you got?
Yeah.
I went back to the 1950s and said the Howdy Doody doll. Howdy Doody time.
She said Doody. All right. Jesse?
I said Barbie.
Shelby Chan?
Raggedy Ann.
Kazman?
You heard me.
All right, you all got it wrong. It was Mr. Potato Head.
Was it?
Mr. Potato Head?
Oh, yeah.
No.
Maybe this they used actual potatoes. All they sold you was just the little pieces.
The pieces, yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe this isn't going to be as easy. I think the first toy I ever saw advertised on television was Malibu Stacy, and she was made of like cornmeal and onions. Kids didn't much like the taste, but they loved the doll.
But she had a new hat.
She got a new hat every year.
The important thing was the hat.
I hear she is America's favorite 8-incher. So, next question. What was the first... Lindsay, you'll like this one. What was the first feature-length animated movie ever released? What was the first... feature-length animated movie ever released.
I might be wrong, but...
I'm going to go with the classic, and if it's wrong, I'll learn something new today.
Chlorophyll? No, it's not Toy Story!
You and I have the same answer. Then.
It's not Toy Story! Oh my god. Somebody hang up on this turkey.
Who's going to need the globe for that one?
I know this is the first something. This is the first something else. I don't think it's the first one.
All right, Hunter, you go first. What do you got?
This is the first one that I remember. Is it Snow White?
Snow White, Lindsay?
Snow White and the Seven Dwarves.
Jesse?
Yeah.
I said Fantasia, which I think is just the first animated movie that also had live-action people in it.
Shelby said Snow White. Kazman?
No, there's no way, because Mary Poppins came before Fantasia.
I'll go last, because I can't write yet. I'll just say it.
You are last.
Steamboat Willie?
That's not a full...
That was just the cartoon.
It wasn't feature length.
Right.
Yeah, it wasn't feature length.
The correct answer, and Beth got it right in the chat too, it was Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Is it Snow White, Pinocchio, Dumbo, Fantasia? No, Bambi, Fantasia. I used to be able to do the whole spiel.
Who are you calling a bitch? I'm not a bitch. You're the bitch, bitch. What?
Right. Yes.
Next question. What TV...
You friggin' fart face.
Ooh.
What TV series showed the first interracial kiss on American network television?
Oh, this is... Okay. This is, like, widely contested, so I'm going to have to assume that you're pulling the popular answer. Because apparently there are a bunch of other answers to this.
Really?
But I'm gonna go with the.
I'm going with what my brain is pulling out at first call.
Jesse, your dad would know this.
I'm going with what most. Yeah, then I'm okay. So then I definitely got it right. And also, again, this is like widely contested because apparently there are a bunch of other shows that did it first, but they weren't as well known.
I did not know that.
So
I did not know that. Hunter, tell us what you got.
Yeah, I forget where I saw this. It's Star Trek classic. There it is. Yeah, the original Star Trek.
Jesse,
because it's Kirk and
it's Star Trek.
I have no guess.
It's Star Trek. Shelby. Neither of you, Cass?
Oh, you said it's Star Trek, and then
that's a white screen.
Shelby, what's your answer?
I don't buy it.
I didn't get it right, so.
Jesse, I tried to throw you a bone.
Yeah, it was Kirk and Uhura, but then there's apparently a lot of like contention about that, and I forget what the other shows were that they're like, no, it was this and that.
So Gina,
you said my dad and I jumped to like Dukes of Hazzard for some reason.
Oh hell no, they show no interracial. The only way they show an interracial kiss on that one is if they didn't show the tree afterwards.
Robotech was one of the cartoons with Claudia and Roy.
Yeah, well, who gives a damn? No, I'm kidding, Lindsay. I'm kidding. Beth got it right. Gina got it right. Michaela said mash.
Oh.
I would like to mash Michaela up into a ball. Okay. Moving on. Clinker.
Clinker.
All right. What were the four?
First of all, I think Clinker was spelled with a K, wasn't it?
I think so. And radio. Radio.
Radio.
Radio. You mean radar? Oh my god! Oh my god! I can't. Are you talking about the black Cuba Gooding Jr.?
He was watching the version of MASH they show in Saudi Arabia. It's the dubbed version. They had to change the name.
Oh my god! All right,
Clinger and Radio.
This one should be.
In that one, the war never ended. I don't know.
This one should be easy. What were the names of the four main characters of Golden Girls?
Do we need full names or just first names?
Just first names.
Okay. Oh, crap.
Oh, yeah. I keep trying to go into Macho Man territory.
Oh, crap. No, I'm just fanning myself with my money going, oh, crap.
Yeah, I never watched this show. I remember one.
I got all four.
Oh, okay.
I have two
of them.
You guys ready?
Two. No, but I'll. Yeah, it's fine. I know two of them. Yeah.
All right, Lindsay, go ahead.
I did have one of them.
My
Blanche, Rose, Dorothy, and Sophia.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
That's what I'm going to say.
Cass?
Old. I forgot Sophia's name.
Who technically is the youngest of all the actresses?
Yeah, Jim was the youngest.
Jesse. Yeah, that's where I messed up. I got Blanche, but then I had Estelle on there. That was her real name.
Estelle Getty.
The oldest one was her real name, Estelle. Yeah, that's where I messed up.
Look up the history of Dorothy. She's a badass. She did at least one or two tours in World War II.
Blanche was the only one that
I remember. White still is. She's still around.
Dorothy's passed.
I know.
All right. I have less faith in that anyone's going to get this one. What awards has an EGOT winner won? EGOT.
A what?
The EGOT.
Oh.
EGOT.
It basically, it's four different award shows, and the initials are EGOT. No one in the chat, by the way, got all of them right.
So is it the case that someone has won all of these?
No, it's just if they won them, what did they win? What is the EGOT? What is EGOT?
Oh, got it.
I actually know this one myself because I'm a award whore. So,
Okay.
There you go. Kaz, we'll start with you because you seem like you got it all.
Hold on.
I think I know two of them, but that's it.
Okay, Shelby, what do you got?
See, that's what I was wondering. That's what I meant. Like, is each one a different award? And for them, yeah, for being an EGOT, did they get all of those?
See, I knew
yeah, it's an acronym. Two
were names, but I couldn't remember what the names were. So I put Emmy, and I couldn't remember if it was Golden Globe or Grammy. So I put Grammy.
Oh, shit. Actually, yeah, you're right. It is Grammy. Sorry,
Cass. It is Grammy.
Yeah.
No, it is Grammy.
Yep.
Okay, so I got Emmy and Grammy. I didn't get Oscar and Tony.
I had Emmy, Grammy, and Tony. I didn't have Oscar. I was blanking on O.
Emmy, Grammy, like Oscar, names. Tony. I can't show it. There it is.
Sierra, gotcha. Hotel, India, Shield.
Echo, Alpha, Lima, Plato. Delta.
Okay.
Shield.
All right, easy one. Throwing you guys a bone.
Stop raining. My ass is going to rot off.
Which member of the Beatles married Yoko Ono? It's an easy one.
I'm out of water.
Go get more water. We'll wait.
Oh, okay.
Actually,
I appreciate it.
What's your answer? And then
John Lennon.
Okay. Cass? Did everyone get John Lennon? Hunter, I'm just assuming you got John Lennon.
Oh, it takes forever. Lennon.
That's
John Lennon.
That looks like Lennon. Sure.
I didn't write John, I wrote Lennon.
Teacher, what are you doing?
It looked like Squiggle.
Hey, I'm not. Let's not talk about.
You're teaching me things, man.
So we got in the
chat. You're teaching me how to write.
We got John Lennon. We got John, Elton John, and then Paul. Okay.
Yes, Yoko Ono married Elton John. Neither of them was happy.
What?
Said you could both do better. All right.
I mean, in fairness, Yoko wasn't happy with John either.
All right, we're gonna switch it up real quick and go. Oh no, it's a Parker!
Oh, he made a crazy face.
He's so
mad.
He's so angry.
Whoa! Calm down.
He is so mad.
He got up, so he was fair play.
He's so angry.
So mad.
The way the light's hitting him, he kind of looks like an angry gremlin.
Yes. Oh, he doesn't appreciate that.
Little snort.
Why are you so mad?
Very angry.
Hmm?
Hey, I'm just waiting for him to snap at Hunter, and it's going to be really unfortunate.
Please, no, watch your nose, man.
He's calmed down. He's okay now. He's okay. His rage is subsiding. Okay. Rage is building.
Urge to kill
rising.
Also, is Hunter's like voice really delayed from his video for anybody else?
At the moment, yeah.
Off and on.
Yeah.
Parker's is fine.
That's because he's always growling. If he's always growling, he can't ever be off.
Just go through space and time. You can't stop. All right, you're doing the show now.
All right. This one's for Parker, then. This one's easy. On the farm, what is a kid?
Write it down.
It's easy. What is a kid? I expect Carter.
You got it.
Parker to get this right. All right, Hunter, let's start with you.
Two answers. Parker told me one of them. So my joke answer, my correct answer is baby goat. My joke answer is it is free labor to have a kid on the farm.
That's true.
They do all the childhood.
Lindsay
is a baby goat.
Is a baby goat. Jesse.
Shelby and I both said baby goat.
Baby goat. I gotta find my pen now.
I'm scared about this, Kaz.
I said goat.
Okay.
You're scared about it.
Well, I can only imagine what you're gonna write.
Well, that's true.
Some of these
looks
are...
like he's winding up or something.
Or he's going to go to sleep.
No, he's winding it down.
I feel like...
I was going to say, when he starts blinking, he's done.
I feel like everyone's going to get this right, but I also feel like I would get this wrong because I'm an idiot. How many colors are there in a rainbow?
Like, standard rainbow?
No, an ultra rainbow.
Visible light, right? Visible light, like prism. Like,
visible
white
prism
light
spectrum.
Enters a prism, what do you get?
A rainbow. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. You need the number or you need the order?
Lights off. Just the number.
So I know the order.
Okay.
Oh.
I do. Everybody knows that.
And I bet you know it by the same acronym I do.
Yes, sir.
Because it's a dude's name.
Shelby's got the same thing written out.
All right. Hunter. No, you know what? Shelby, since you got it all, I want to hear your answer. Yes.
7. Red, orange, yellow, green, yep. Blue, indigo, violet.
It is 7. Jesse, same thing?
Yeah.
7. Hunt 2.
You are indeed.
Lindsay.
Come on, white balance.
Oh, so I'm the only loser that actually wrote out the word 7.
Yes.
You did it correct. It. Anything under 12 should be written out.
Fucking nerd.
Is that true?
Other letters that I had to worry about.
Fair enough. I know. Roy G. Biv.
Roy G. Biv.
That's how it should be. No, that's right. That's wrong. What happened? My phone's fucking up.
Your phone said no.
Oh, dear God. Okay. Another easy one. I'm going to throw out another bone for you. What is Earth's largest continent? These are all basic trivia questions. Chad, you were so close. 17 is almost the answer. Beth is on a roll. Beth, you are smart.
I think this is easy, but I can never remember between two of them, and I feel like I'm going to end up messing with
them. I'm doing the same thing.
All right.
It's one of two, and I can't remember which one.
Yeah. Right.
Kaz, you first.
What was the question?
What is Earth's largest continent? And you can't say Louis Anderson.
Africa?
Okay.
I don't know. I'm trying. Sorry, my phone just broke. Literally,
it's a 7.
Oh no!
Oh shit!
Hunter,
restart it.
I went with Antarctica.
Lindsay,
because
it's that or another one.
Antarctica.
Jesse,
I went with the other one. Asia.
Shelby Chan.
Right, that's the other one.
It's Asia.
Is it Asia?
I never remember
Asia.
Well, see, half the time anymore, they also label it as Eurasia because it's all one big mass.
It actually depends on where you're at, because different countries have different global maps, and that's fascinating to me.
Yeah.
Like there's not 7 continents in every person's map.
I sat there debating whether I was going to write Eurasia or Asia. I was like,
I think one of the Scandinavian
Eurasia, yep.
And one of the Scandinavian countries only teach that there are 4 continents.
They attach Africa with.
It's like it's no, it's just the Americas, Eurasia, Africa, and Australia, and then Antarctica doesn't count as a continent
because it doesn't have
because there's nobody
full-time living population.
Yep.
Right.
Yeah.
Which makes sense, I guess. But
that's what threw me off. I can never remember if it makes a difference.
It may have been bigger before, you know, all the ice melting.
So Antarctica's going to be the second one, right?
Yeah, Antarctica.
Yeah, that might be it, too.
All right, this is another bone.
It's got to be the second one, because I knew it was one of those two.
There's another bone I'm throwing you. And this one's topical for what we've been talking about lately. Area 51 is located in which state? Also known as Groom Lake, but Area 51, located in which state?
Oh, shit.
Now I'm second-guessing myself.
Yeah, I'm second-guessing myself shit. Here, but I think I'm going to go with my first instinct.
I think you're right. I think I'm wrong.
Well, I know you're wrong.
Okay,
but
yeah.
Damn!
The fact that everyone is second guessing themselves is making me second guess myself, but I'm going with it. It's fine.
I'm gonna just.
It's already done.
All right. I'll swing it over to Hunter. Hunter,
if you
first.
End up being right, then I'll admit that. Like,
I'm now realizing I'm thinking of Roswell, but I wrote New Mexico.
Lindsay?
And that's not right.
Went with New Mexico.
Jesse?
I had the exact same problem that Hunter just had, and I started second guessing myself. I'm pretty sure I know what state it's in.
Shelby?
And yeah.
I don't want to.
Shelby?
Texas is what I put down.
What is it?
I put Texas because I couldn't remember.
Kaz?
I think I got this wrong.
Kaz got it right. You were the only one that got it right.
Kaz got it right.
Yeah, really?
It is Nevada.
I wrote down Arizona first.
Yeah, I wrote down New Mexico, and I was like, fuck, that's Roswell. And then like I was like, it's Nevada. Like, I already wrote it down, and we're starting. So.
Yep.
My brain went the same way when I switched to New Mexico. It was Roswell.
I really thought that was one everyone knew. I'm sorry. I feel bad about that. I did know it.
I'm not good at geography.
But it's aliens.
It has never been relevant to me because I'm not going there. So, like, what
right, am but, I doing? But Lindsay should know because she's put up with me for 15 years at this point, and I talk about Area 51 a lot. So
I should know. I mean, again, I also do that, but it's that thing of I can never remember if that and Roswell are in the same place or not. So
all right, I would get this one wrong.
What's to be done?
A lot of geography questions here.
One more geography question. What country has the most natural lakes?
Oh, can we? What country?
Natural lakes. Most
natural lakes.
Yes.
Oh.
You want to skip it? Should we just skip it?
Why? Yes.
All right. It's Canada.
I mean, I'll, damn it. I was going to say, I'll just throw one out there.
Can?
This one's way more
That's
fun.
What I was referencing when I said, oh, can we? Canada. Oh, Canada.
Surprising amount of people in the chat got that one right. Congratulations.
With right? All right.
I like this one. This is a fun one. And I did not know this one either. The unicorn is the national animal of which country?
Oh, me. I just heard this recently.
We just did this. Yeah, you said you didn't know this. This was one of our questions from this.
I don't remember what we talked about.
But I don't remember what the country was. We did it in the other direction. It was somebody gave us the country, and we were like, we had to guess what fictional animal was there.
Yeah.
Like national animal. Oh, man. Oh, wait a minute. I think I do remember. I'm guessing, though. All right, I'm ready.
All right. Cast first. All of them.
All of them.
That's a good guess. Let's go to Shelby.
Oh, no.
Go for it.
No.
No, it's a good guess.
Okay,
go for it.
Sweden is what I put.
That is a good guess. That is a good guess. Jesse?
That is a good guess.
I said Norway.
It's just as good as guess
as Jesse's.
That's
also a good guess.
Lindsay?
I have no clue. My brain just putzed out.
That's the best guess.
I think now that I'm wrong, but I wrote New Zealand.
Well, it's definitely
for
not.
For some reason, I feel like it was New Zealand.
That might be it, actually.
Actually might be it, yeah.
It's definitely not Zimbabwe, like Chad Gray said. No, it's Scotland.
Damn it! That's what I was gonna write too.
Shit. Ireland.
Tanner.
Scotland. I should have known. I'm from there. Apparently,
somewhere Tanner's rolling over in his bucket. Someone said Ireland. All right. So, real quick update on the scores.
No, that's Ireland. He needed Ireland.
Lindsay, Hunter, and Shelby are all tied. Jesse and Kaz are one behind them. So it is literally anybody's game at this point.
A close game.
I'm gonna win this. I'm winning it.
All right. Okay, I like this one because tomorrow's horse time. The name of which African animal means river horse? African animal means river horse. Oh, yeah.
I got it.
Hunter was quick on the draw on that one.
I'm going to go for a weird one.
I don't remember why I know this, but I got it.
All right. I need a thumbs up from Jesse.
I came up with a random fucking animal for it. Let's go.
All right, Hunter, what do you got?
No, I'll go last because I'm dead serious about this one. I'm certain I got it.
All right, Kaz, you first.
I got this.
Hippo. Shelby.
Oh, hippopotamus is a good guess.
Kelpie.
The hell's a Kelpie?
It's a water horse. It's a mythical water horse. I didn't know.
I said giraffe.
All right, Lindsay.
I also went with the hippopotamus.
Huntu?
Hippopotamus is a good guess.
Lindsay and Kaz are correct. It is indeed the hippopotamus.
They are.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas.
No.
Damn, now I'm 2 points out of the lead.
We were on mythical creatures and my brain just didn't leave. It was like, oh, more magic. Let's go.
Honestly, I'm going down the
that
list.
No one says seahorse is disappointing to me, though.
I wanted to put that. I was thinking
it
about that.
It means river horse. I'm going to go with seahorse.
Sea monkeys.
Sea ponies.
Sea, which stands in for river, and a horse, which also equals horse.
Horse.
All right. That's the transitive property.
So, random sea monkey. Horse. What is the hottest planet in the solar system? The hottest planet in the solar system.
I mean, it would have to be.
And no, Jesse, it's not Planet Booty.
God, you got to change your hands.
I feel like this is. Now that I've said this, I feel like it's wrong, but I'm going with it anyway.
I'm doing it. Oh, unless.
The sun is not a planet, Michaela.
No, I'm changing.
I'll be waiting for somebody to say
I'm
that.
I'm changing it.
All right, let's start with Jesse.
I think I'm wrong.
Uranus. No, it's Mercury.
Said Mercury.
All right, Kaz or Hunter? Sure, why not?
I said Mercury.
Lindsay?
I also went with Venus because it's gases trapped stuff in.
It is Venus.
It's nah, I was afraid of that.
It traps everything in on the planet. Yeah.
I assure you it was Venus.
And I and Shelby had the same thought, I guarantee you. Close to sun equals hot.
Close to sun, yeah.
It's gotta be.
I just know they have a bit of the time putting satellites on there.
All right, so let's...
It's everywhere, man.
We'll do a couple more here.
You have no idea how little that narrows it down.
Hello, Quinn.
A little bit.
We've got fact-checking going on.
No, the sun is not a planet. The sun is a star.
The sun is a mass of incandescent gas.
Jesse,
a planet precludes the idea that you can land on it.
Jesse, if you dare question the validity of quizbreaker.com.
It's apparently because of the average. Because the side of Mercury that's not facing the sun is negative 300 degrees.
300 degrees? Damn!
Because it's in the shadow.
Yep. That makes sense.
That sucks. I didn't even think about that. I knew when I said it, or when I wrote it down, I'm like, it's got to be wrong, because it's too obvious, it's too easy, yeah, but I couldn't think of what would be. That makes sense.
I mean, like, I was thinking, like, damn, well, some of these other questions, I'm like,
yeah. All right,
this is a super nerd question. Which of Newton's laws states that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction?
What kind of question is this again?
Super smart.
No, say it again.
Super nerd.
Okay, Newton's law of motion for every action is equal and opposite reaction. Which one is it?
Yes.
And which one is it? Oh, well, Jesse, if this ain't a quiz bowl question, I don't know what is, and I do not know.
Are you for sure on yours?
So I will be.
Oh my god, I don't remember my types of energy.
Yeah, I'm like, I knew this for damn certain in high school.
Yeah. Yep. We would have been beating each other to the buzzer on this one.
I know that one.
All right, I got a guess.
All right. Sure, Hunter, let's go with you.
I went with third because I'm pretty sure the first one is the at motion tends to stay in motion. And I don't remember what the second is.
Because the first one's inertia.
Yeah.
So, but I don't remember what the other two are.
Lindsay?
Yeah.
Is one of them, it's the kinetic law. I don't remember which number it is. It's been a long time since high school science class.
I'll have to look that one up. Jesse?
I said the second.
I said third.
Because I don't know. I don't remember the laws.
Casualty.
Yes.
Causality. I said casualty. Fuck. It is third.
Damn.
So Shelby and Hunter. Yeah. Although I need to check Lindsay's. What the kinetic? What is it?
Because each one's a different type of energy, but I don't remember which one is which.
I didn't know we could do numbers.
Right? I was like, actually,
I assumed you only wanted the number.
Right.
Yeah.
Because it said which
I assumed you just wanted the number.
I wouldn't know what that law is.
It's called in. I don't remember.
I knew it wasn't the first, so I was like, 50-50 shot, two.
All right.
Yeah. It's fine. I'm not worried about it.
Which law was it? Read
the the third law of motion. I don't know. Well, I look like a fucking nerd.
Saying the best Spice Girl is the third one?
I'm not worried about it.
Rest will stay.
He gave the third. It was an object at motion, or for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction.
It's the third law of motion.
And then the second That's one the third is, law.
Yeah, for,
all right.
Yeah, that Fine. Was the question.
I'm going to ask a stupid one, since this is too much. In the state of Georgia, it's illegal to eat what with a fork?
Sure. Let's just do it. I've
heard this before.
Let's just do it.
In the state of Georgia.
I have the Seinfeld answer for this. That's it.
It's illegal to eat what with a fork?
I'm literally just writing the first thing that came to my head.
All right, Lindsay, go ahead. I want to know what you got.
Pizza.
Oh, that'd be a terrible law. Hunter?
I would be arrested so fast.
I went with soup, question mark.
No soup for you.
This seems like a bad idea. It seems like a bad... Okay, actually, that's not... The Seinfeld answer would be a candy bar. Because there's a whole episode where people start eating, like, Snickers with a fork and a knife, and people were freaking out about it. Or they're eating, like, M&Ms with a spoon. It's a whole thing. But I'm going with soup. Because that's a bad plan, and people should be made to not do it. I want to
see somebody try that.
Jesse?
I said watermelon.
Shelby?
So specific.
Is that what? French fries? French fries?
Yeah.
Kaz?
Yeah.
I actually have heard this ridiculous law before, but I don't remember what it is.
It's fried chicken.
Really?
Huh. Yeah.
Huh. So I went okay. with the wrong racial stereotype.
Voting.
All right, one more, only because...
No, hold on, I need four more because I'm behind by like 3 points.
Oh, yeah.
That's fair. Okay, math.
Oh, yeah.
All right, fuck, three more. Okay, what animal could be seen on...
I was doing a bit.
Oh, okay. We'll do two more. Which animal could be...
We got a Call of Duty to get to.
Which animal could be seen on the Porsche logo?
On the what logo?
Porsche. I don't know. Is it Porsche?
Dibbik?
Dibbik?
Is it the Dibbik?
Dibbik. I don't know cars.
Boy, this is going to suck.
Porsche.
All right, we got it.
No, hold on.
Who eats fried chicken with a fork? I don't know. Cultured people.
When it's greasy.
Apparently, nobody in Georgia, unless you want to go to jail.
All right, this one's a stumper, apparently.
Yeah, I have no clue.
It's time. Cass?
It's wrong, but I'm writing it down.
Yeah, same.
Shelby?
I said a horse.
Jesse?
I said a big cat.
Lindsay?
I also went with horse.
And Huntu.
It's horse time.
Everyone got it right, but Jesse.
But it's not. It's a Mustang.
Dang.
Is it really?
Yeah.
No!
I don't even remember.
Just can't think of that's got to be a Mustang, right?
That's a good question.
I guess other cars Jesse, look that up. I guess because engines have horsepower.
There is a. I have not seen this Porsche shield in forever.
There is.
Yeah, there's a little.
Yeah, I know. That's new.
What the shield looked like, I would have said deer.
I actually started to say deer, and then I was like, nah, I'm gonna go with big cat.
I like Chad's.
I couldn't remember what the emblem was at all. So
I like Chad's answer: jellyfish. I would drive a car with a
jellyfish
on it.
Right?
Yeah. Right. Every time I think of like a Porsche, I just think of like what's on the back of the car. And it's
I just did it because Porsche sounded caps. Like horse, and I was like, "Let's go with that."
I love that thinking. All right, last question. Last question. This one is worth 5 points.
Okay. Wow! Well, that seems.
What I don't even know how you measure this.
Does that mean there's five answers?
No, there's one answer. I don't even know how you measure this, but this is on the list. So, what is the rarest M&M color?
Current or old?
And I just eliminated the question.
Yeah, that's a real... All
right, so we're going to eliminate the question. The answer was brown.
There were two shades of brown because there used to be dark brown and light brown.
They were very inclusive with M&Ms.
Uh-huh.
Damn, would have still been correct, though.
All right, we're going to keep... This one's still worth 5 points.
Thank you.
This one's a little bit easier.
I think you should just give me and Jesse the points.
I think technically he would have gotten it, too.
Lindsay said it was the most common because there's two browns.
No.
Browntown.
Brown.
Because there used to be two browns before they blew out. Because there was a lighter tan and then the typical brown that you see now.
Four.
And that's on Saturday. All right.
But the coffee M&Ms ruined that. Because
last question.
Yeah, see, that's the thing. That having a bunch of different ones just messes it all up.
Coffee M&Ms sounds disgusting.
Oh, it's better than you think.
Chocolate. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's so good.
Which country invented ice cream?
Damn it.
Okay, you completely broke up. What? All I heard was country and ice cream.
Which country invented ice cream?
Country invented ice cream.
Oh, I don't like this.
It's the country of Ice Creamia.
Ice Creamia?
Oh my, I don't...
I gotta throw out a guess.
Yeah, me too.
There's only so many countries out there.
Throwing out a guess. Right, one of them's gotta be right. There can't be more than five countries. According to the news,
there's the U.S. of A.
USSR.
And that's the only one that matters.
All right, let's start with Hunter. What do you got?
I got one.
What do you got?
I went with Poland.
Poland. Lindsay?
I don't know why. Don't ask.
I went with Russia.
Russia. Jesse?
That's a good guess.
I went with Italy.
That would have been my
gelato.
Guess.
That's gelato.
Well, that's a good Shelby? Guess, too.
I said England.
Kazman?
Okay.
A.
Well, it started with a cold one and then went away.
It's actually China.
Really?
China.
I mean, really? They technically invented pasta also.
Although they probably just took it from us. Because China takes a lot of our intellectual properties and... You know,
remixes
geographically,
them.
Geographically, I got closest.
Let's count these scores.
That's
up.
Fair. That's fair.
I'm still wrong, but
parts of China can be cold.
Parts of China are really cold.
Lindsay and Hunter are tied.
Look at that.
So
sudden death question.
We have to have a sudden death question.
I'm not as dumb as I look.
Oh, I got it. I got it. I'm gonna look up.
I might be.
Hardest trivia question in the world.
Oh, here we go.
No.
Oh, this is a terrible idea.
This was seriously. This was Shelby's.
I lost my
ground. No, I don't like that. I don't like that at all.
You dropped this, King.
Lindsay has.
Well, Lindsay's actually got one.
Well, of course I'm
you
queen,
and she picked it up. The queen.
But if he gets this right, does that mean that you have to bring the crown tomorrow and he gets to wear it?
All right.
She's not coming tomorrow.
I have to work.
I wish she was. I wish everybody was going to be here.
I mean,
but
honestly, if I wasn't opening Saturday morning, I would come up afterwards. But I'm not getting off work at 9:30 and then getting back up at 6:30 a.m. after traveling to Perryville and back. I'm sorry.
But you're the queen. You count.
You don't have to. You
wherever.
Don't have to justify. You don't have to justify
that's
to
fair.
Us. It's understandable.
All right, I got it. Shelby, you're in this.
Here's my ass is going to rot off.
Here's
are we all answering?
No, here's the rule. It's Lindsay and Hunter, but if Shelby gets it right and they get it wrong, she keeps her crown.
She retains her title.
Champion's advantage. All right. What are two things you can never eat for breakfast?
Oh,
what?
two things you can never eat for breakfast.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah,
I've been doing these things all day at work because I'm
confidence on Hunter is like intimidating.
Oh, now, I'm done. I got it.
Now here's the other thing though. If Lindsay
give this answer so that I win.
If Lindsay and Hunter get it right, but Shelby gets it wrong, then they're still tied. We have to go to another one, and Shelby's still in it. So, Lindsay,
I got it.
Lunch and dinner.
Hunter,
that's also what I said. Lunch and dinner.
Shelby.
Apparently that's not the hardest one.
All right, well, here we go again. We gotta get another one. Shelby, you're still in it.
Oh no.
What
I'm running out of places to write.
What word is spelled incorrectly in every single dictionary?
Incorrect.
Is it wrong if got I it. Spell it incorrectly? Because I can't spell worth crap.
Never mind, you all already got it.
I got it.
Yeah, you already got it. Like literally everyone jumped in that quickly.
Lindsay didn't get it.
I don't want to do this
also
anymore.
On the previous question, I wish I had turned it over because I hadn't marked it out yet, but I still had where I had soup. What can you never eat for breakfast? Soup? Is it soup?
I don't like I don't like these questions anymore. I don't like riddles.
Life is
That's all I was doing the other day.
Oh, shit. I actually remember this riddle from when I was a kid. This was one of my favorite riddles. I'm going to ask this one.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Okay.
A cowboy rode into town on Friday. He stayed in town for 3 days and rode out on Friday. How is that possible?
I got it. I got it. I got it. I will give the answer to you right now without writing it down.
What's the answer?
I don't feel like writing it. I don't have much space.
What's the answer?
We'll go first.
Yes.
Are we ready?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Okay, his horse is named Friday.
Yeah,
his horse is named Friday.
You know how long it took me to figure that out as a kid? Fuck you guys. Last one, and then goddamn it, if you guys all get this one right, then it's just over. What has a face and two hands, but no arms or legs?
I got it.
Really?
I'm good.
What? Yep. Shannon, next hit him up with the what gets wetter as it dries.
What's the answer?
I got that one too.
What's the answer? Clock.
Shannon's is either a watch or a clock. Jesse's is a towel.
All right. Well, the end of the show. Everyone's a champion because I don't want to ask any more questions.
To finish that bit out. All right. A man is hung in the middle of a barn. There's nothing around.
Yeah, he's standing on an ice block. He hung himself, and it melted underneath him. You just have to hit me with the damn it.
I'm trying to, is it Ryan?
It's Ryan who's getting it right. Right? He was the one who was playing the other side of it. It's Dwight and Ryan, right? Dwight keeps asking Ryan all the.
It's not Jim. Ryan or Dwight and Jim.
I don't think
it's Dwight and Ryan. It's definitely Dwight asking the.
I think it's Ryan.
Next week.
I think it's Ryan is the other side.
Before
Ryan goes crazy.
The next time we're all together, it's going to be Hunter versus Lindsay versus Shelby in the Ultimate Championship with questions curated by myself, Jesse Kimball, and Kaz.
You're not going to get all together and get questions together.
We will start a chat and get these questions.
Shut up. Exactly.
Yeah.
Separate chat channel. We can get this pulled together.
We will be the bosses next time.
Well, good. For once, you can put the work into it.
I just read from a webpage.
Put you back into it.
All right. That's going to do it for us tonight. Boy, it's a humdinger. We're going to go play the Car of Duty. We'll see you guys tomorrow for a special...
Car of Duty.
For a special edition of Live Horses... Live from the Hendrick stable.
Someone's gonna get trampled.
Yes,
it's gonna be a party like you don't believe. Next week we do it all again, guys. Thank you for joining us tonight, for having some fun with us. For myself, for Jesse, for Lindsay, for Shelby, for Kaz, for Hunter, and for Tanner because he's probably in here somewhere. Thank you. We'll see you tomorrow. Shelby, take us out. Nope, it was completely silent. Shelby, do it again.
This is where we say goodbye.